Father of Mercies, we commend our beloved Sister Pat. In the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise in the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings you bestowed upon Pat in this life, for they were many. She in turn bestowed them upon us. Signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ.
Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant Pat and help us who remain. Comfort one another with the assurances of faith. Till we all meet in Christ and are with you and our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
You know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out in their need and strengthen their goodness. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord.
And let perpetual light shine upon her.
May Pat rest in peace.
Amen.
May Pat's soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son. May he take Pat unto himself in the kingdom of heaven where Lazarus is poor no longer, and bless everyone who remains, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
In the waters of baptism, Pat died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share eternal glory in the kingdom of heaven. On the day of her christening, long ago, she was brought to church by parents and loved ones. She was baptized and wore a christening gown. Promises, vows were made, and they were kept. A life of love, devotion, and family. As a parish, as co-workers, as friends and family, we now clothe her in Christ. And let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son who died on the cross was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant Pat, who has gone to her rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. At this time, we invite Lynn Lascano to come forward for the first reading.
A reading from the book of Proverbs, 31:10-31. A good wife, a good mother, a good godmother, a good daughter, a good sister-in-law, a good aunt, a good friend. Who can find? Her worth is far above rubies. The heart of her family trusts in her. And nothing shall they lack. She renders them good and not evil all the days of her life. She opens her hand to the needy and extends her hand to the poor. She is robed in strength and dignity and cheerfully faces whatever may come. She opens her mouth with wisdom. Her tongue is guided by kindness. She tends to the affairs of her household and eats not the bread of idleness. Her husband, her son, her family and friends come forward and bless her. All praise her, saying, "Many women have done superbly, but you surpass them all." Charm is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a God-revering woman is much to be praised. Place before her the fruit of her hands. Wherever people gather, her deeds speak her praise. The word of the Lord.
Beyond my wants, beyond my A reading from Paul's letter to Timothy. As for me, I am already being poured out as a libation, and the time of my departure has come. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, there is reserved for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Friends, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountainside. And after he had sat down, his disciples gathered around him, and he began to teach them. How blessed are the poor in spirit. The reign of God is theirs. Blessed, too, are the sorrowing. They shall be consoled. Blessed are the lowly, they shall inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for holiness, they shall have their fill. Blessed are they who show mercy, mercy shall be theirs. Blessed are the single-hearted, for they shall see God. Blessed too the peacemakers, they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those persecuted for holiness' sake, the reign of God is theirs. And blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of slander against you because of me. Be glad and rejoice, for your reward in heaven is great. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed are the clean of heart. They will see God. Blessed are the clean of heart. They will see God. Blessed are the clean of heart. They will see God. This heart is now entwined with the Creator in ways that we can only imagine, because this is a great heart, to say the least. I know. I have shared that heart for more than 30 years. I'm a film buff, and I know every genre very well. Older films, because I don't understand the new ones. And I have a favorite in every genre, whether it's a Western or a comedy or a sci-fi, whatever it is. But when I want to really sink into myself, become a child, perhaps again, be relieved after a day or a week of many funerals and weddings, there's only one film that I go to. And you're all starting to think about that, aren't you? I get my comfortable chair prepared. I get a box of tissues. and I slip E.T. into the machine. And there is the one moment for me, in the genius of Spielberg, at the very end, when an economy of words betrays an incredible wisdom. And you know what those words are. By this time, I've gone through 3/4 of the tissues. And E.T. puts, you can see his beating heart. And he puts his finger to Elliot's head. And what does he say? Go with me on this. Be good. The number of fingers and hands on her heart number in the thousands. And from the day of her birth, and I knew her parents, the most gentle and humble of fingers and hands were placed on her heart in those early formative stages. Wonderful siblings all in love with each other, loving parents in love with their children and each other. Not very far from where I grew up, actually, although we didn't know one another then. And this great heart overflowed with the gifts that they placed there and they shared and they nurtured together. The human heart is the receptacle of everything that we are. It contains all of the good, all of the greatness, and some of the stuff we're not too proud of. It contains it all, and it is the vessel by which we will be judged as we go through our lives. And this is that kind of heart that comes along once in a lifetime. The French philosopher Voltaire was supposed to have said that God is a comedian playing to an audience afraid to laugh. That's why she was born, to give credence to that statement. A great heart, indeed, a very, very great heart. And she would want all of you to share in this wonderful moment. And so I'm going to invite you to share with me, because if you think I'm going to do this alone, I'm not. There's another one of the Beatitudes called, Blessed are they who mourn, they will be comforted. We are here to embrace all of you and all of you and provide comfort to one another. But I know one thing about Pat Moore. She would not want to be held close by grief. Never be held close by grief, but by the memories of every heart in this room. So I'm going to ask you to do something for me and with me. I'm going to give you 30 seconds. I want you to close your eyes, and please don't say, oh, Father, not that old chestnut closing our eyes. Yes. And I want you to call to mind the most wonderful, loving, singular, perhaps outrageous moment that you shared with Pat Moore. And I want you to come out of that 30-second eye-closed trance with a smile and with love in your heart, even a giggle, perhaps, or two, and start now. Time's up. Everybody smiling? That's what she would want. She told me last night, I came over to spend time, we had a private conversation, the two of us. If you don't think that is scriptural, let me read this to you from Ecclesiastes. What gain have the workers from their toil? I've seen the business that God has given to everyone to be busy with. He has made everything suitable for its time, put a sense of past and future into our minds. Yet they cannot find out what God has done from the beginning to the end. I know there is nothing better for them than to be happy, enjoy themselves as long as they live. Moreover, it is God's gift that all should eat and drink and take pleasure in all their toil. I know that whatever God does endures forever. Nothing can be added or taken from it. God has done this so that we should stand in awe before him. Pat Moore stood in awe before God. She stood in awe before God, and in that standing in awe, she drew from God unbelievable power that augmented the unbelievably powerful personality she already had. And we all experienced it. And it was wonderful to recall that last evening, talking to family, friends, and so many others. Her faith was her guidepost. It truly was. She loved being in this church. She decorated the church every Christmas. One day when we were trying to find a Christmas present to send to the parishioner, she said, well, she actually never suggested anything. It kind of arrived in a box the next day. There was no discussing things. It was what was best. And you'll like it when you see it, whether you like it or not. And so she decided the best thing we can do was get coffee mugs and have the whole Christmas scene printed on them as gifts for the parishioners. They are now highly prized, sought-after relics of 10 years ago. You look in some, do you have one of those mugs that Pat had made? I lost mine, I broke it. I first met her many, many years ago when I began to help these good people out in funeral service. And the parish, before I got here, I was a hospital chaplain, and I can remember sitting in the kitchen and my predecessor was not doing such a good job, and I can talk about him because he's now up there with her. Oh, God only knows. But anyway, I don't know if he's happy actually up there now, but I remember very distinctly, and you know, there's a way, as people have known me for a long time after the years go by and we become good friends, they kind of drop the father thing, which is great with me because I love my name. My mother and father gave it to me. Before I was father, I was Michael. And after some time, people all of a sudden stumble into, Michael, a father. No, it's okay, you can call me Michael, it's okay. Usually takes a few years. It took Pat 10 minutes. And as I sat at the table, I sat there, she said, Michael, you know, the guy at the, and it could have gone like this. You know, father, he's troubled, he's not doing well, and you want to change ministry. Maybe you should apply for the job. Or it could have been, you know, father, he's really not meant for this job. He should be in another ministry. Nothing subtle like that. Michael, the guy's a jerk. When are you going to apply for the parish? You know, real subtle. Just slide it right in like that. And she used my favorite phrase, which I have borrowed from her and I use all the time. You know, he's nervous and jerky. That was her favorite phrase to describe other, and I use it all the time now. It really, well, you can have it, it's okay. That was our girl. That's what we loved about her. When dessert came at your house, it wasn't a matter of a demure slice of cake with a fork on the plate. She would go to the closet and bring out 27 pounds of various chocolates and throw them on, here, have a chocolate. Which she adored. She adored. She loved life, she ran with life, and she lived it to the fullest, and that's why missing her hurts. Because as I said at the beginning, God is a comedian playing to an audience afraid to laugh, and once in a while, we get somebody like Pat in our lives who lets us know that life can be lived, sometimes laughed at, sometimes laughed with, but it all came, once again, from that great heart. Blessed are the clean of heart, they will see God. And that enrapture with that heart is going on right now, and in whatever way we communicate with the divine, God is saying to her, you left this world better than you found it. I gave you a purpose and the drive and the sense of humor and the love, and boy, did you run with it. I believe that all of us have that. I believe that every human being has those gifts in their heart, but what you make of the gifts, again, as I said in the beginning, is the measure of how you will be judged and loved. Rob and I have done many, many funerals in this space, many. And there have been times when very nice people have been sitting here, but maybe only a handful, and one wonders, is that all? And then other times, the church is filled and people get up and give their tributes, and you know that someone took those gifts and they ran with them. And that's selflessness. That's the ability to put others ahead of yourself. And if you're a priest or you're in funeral service, you know what that's all about. Because your life, when those calls come in, goes on the back burner. And it's always inconvenient, isn't it? It's always at a time when you've got other plans. But remember, man proposes and God disposes. And God puts us in those moments for the love and the service of other people, and that was the hallmark of her life. Blessed are they who mourn, they will be comforted. Blessed are the clean of heart, they will see God. The Lord uses the word blessed 8 or 9 times in that gospel, reminding those people on the side of the hill, now that you've heard from me that you are blessed of God, you will pay it forward. That's the phrase we use today. You've been blessed, now you must go and bless others. And that's how the church was built, in discipleship, blessing other people. How could they have done it? Paul poured himself out in that well-chosen reading. I've run the good race. I fought the good fight. I have been poured out like a libation. Pat Moore ran the good race, fought the good fight, especially the last few years, and poured herself out in the service and the love of her family and other people for her entire life. And if that is not discipleship, I do not know what is. And when you read Paul's letters, he's always encouraging those early small Christian communities, don't give up. Don't give up. Live by what I have told you about Jesus Christ, and your community will survive and it will thrive. And in many ways, she kept up my continuing education when I had my moments, when I was down, and she encouraged me to do exactly the same thing. And you might find that strange for a priest, but I've surrounded myself with people who have done so much for me in the way of sustaining my life, my vocation, and the loss of my mother only a year ago. And you were there with Pat for me. I will never forget it. Be good up there. Don't cause too much trouble. We shall miss you. Rest in peace. Please rise. At this time, I invite my good friend and family friend Kim Manza to come forward and share with us the intercessions. The response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. God, the Almighty Father, has done great things for us. Now we place these prayers and petitions before him.
For Pat, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of saints, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For our sister who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For our deceased relatives and friends, the Moore and Joseph families, especially John and Jean Josephs, Ben and Regina Felice, and Aunt Maggie DiAgostino, may they have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, may they see God's face to face, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For Dr. McNamara and her staff at John Thayer Cancer Center, Summer and all the infusion staff, for all the medical teams who helped Pat, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the family and friends of Pat, may they be consoled in the grief by the Lord who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, we be gathered together again in God's kingdom. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Strengthen us, Lord, in our prayers and in our faith each and every day through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. At this time, we invite those to go forward and bring up our gifts and flowers. Pat and Rob's godchildren, Jenna Sasso, Amy Lockchin, Christine Josephs, James T. Joseph Jr., Colby Montaigne, and Caius Bernarducci. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands to the praise and glory of his name for our good and the good of all his church. Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings that through these acts of devotedness in this difficult time we may pass over to the glory of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
is truly right and just, our duty and salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, eternal God and Holy Father. He is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, and the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the hosts of angels adore your majesty and rejoice in your presence. May our voices be one with theirs in a triumphant hymn of praise.
God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the
You are indeed holy, O Lord. You are the font of holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending your Spirit upon them, that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks, you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we will be gathered into one by the power of the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to a fullness of charity. With Francis, our Pope, Kevin, our Bishop, clergy, religious, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember your servant Pat, whom you've called to this day from your life, from this world to yourself. Grant that she was united with your Son in a death like his, may join him now in glorious resurrection. Remember all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, her beloved husband Joseph, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, praising and glorifying you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from all evil. Grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from distress and safe from all evil, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accord with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit."
We share a sign of God's peace.
Take me a channel of your peace.
hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. O Master, grant that I may never cease so much to be consoled as to console. Understood as you understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. We invite those to come forward who wish to receive communion to please do so. But if you do not wish to receive, you may be seated. Okay, who did I say? You have one? Who was the other? You have the other. And the deacon is with me. Okay? Okay. Go with Nick is going to show you where to go. Body of Christ, Rob. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
I will come to you in the silence.
Body of Christ.
I will lift you from all your
body of Christ.
You will hear my voice. I claim you as my choice. Be still and know I am here.
Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
I am hope for all.
The body of
Christ. I am eyes for all.
Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Body of Christ. I am with you.
Body of Christ.
I have called to reach my name.
Body of Christ, Michael.
Come and follow me.
Body of Christ, Nick.
I will bring you home.
At this time, we invite Bobby Moore to come forward and share with us remarks of remembrance.
I'm here today to tell you what is in my dad's broken heart because he knows it won't come out correctly right now. He wants me to start by thanking Dr. Donna McNamara and her staff and everyone at the John Thayer Cancer Center in Hackensack, all of the nurses and techs at their infusion center, especially her newest best friend, Summer, who treated her with such respect over the last 4 years, Angela Mania and all the funeral directors who offered their prayers, help, equipment, and guidance for everything we needed this past week for Pat's funeral, especially the members of the Passaic County Funeral Directors Association, were coming to pay tribute to their fellow member last night. I must single out, from all the funeral directors, her boyfriend DJ Wright. Their relationship went places that was way beyond mere colleagues, and I'm certain that Pat put the idea in my head to see if he would like to help care for her at the end. Most everything that you have shared in the past couple days to honor my wife has been the result of his love for Pat and his ability to elevate our profession to heights that I have never seen before. There are no words. To Kim, Lenny, Amy, Catherine, Judith, Shemp, and everyone who kept her final hours filled with comfort and love, and both of our extended families for their love and prayers. Debbie Mania for being her constant companion, either in person or on the phone, literally for hours at a time, and being her contact to the real world throughout her years of sickness. That meant so much to her. Past NFDA chaplain, Father Michael Lombardo, our spiritual advisor, for all his support always. And Pat's dear friend, Father S.T. Sutton, who spoke last night at the wake, and all the clergy here today. Also like to thank Deacon George Kelder, who is also the executive director of New Jersey State Funeral Directors Association, a true friend of ours who we have been privileged to have participate in too many family funerals. Our Lady of Consolation, this beautiful church we are in that Pat and I call home, has an incredible staff and Lazarus Committee, which I thank too, along with everyone who is a part of today's liturgy. Mr. Jack Griffin and Dr. Anthony Bernaducci, Pat's two favorite musicians, yes, even more than her own husband, for granting her wish today for them to play at her funeral mass. Dad's sister and my dear Aunt Dana and her store Blooms of Wayne for all the beautiful flowers. She is truly an artist at what she does. Our family at Batesville Casket, Abigail Press, and Crater Vault for their guidance and suggestion to make everything special for Pat. Our friends and colleagues from the National Funeral Directors Association who came in from across the country, especially Executive Director Christine Pepper, who Pat lovingly referred to as my other boss while I was NFDA president. Especially newly installed NFDA President Jack Mitchell IV. She talked for months, Jack, about wanting to be in Baltimore this week for your installation, as she was so fond of you. So I guess since that did not work out, she's making sure you're gonna do your new job right and tested you with your first presidential funeral assignment after just 48 hours on the job. Typical Pat. And finally, for all the countless emails, phone calls, social media posts, food, and truly unique Pat Moore stories from everyone I've talked to, they've been truly overwhelming, but so sincerely appreciated. Oh, and I almost forgot. Our local county of Passaic for the amazing beautification of our funeral home property. Love them so much. As we pass by that in a little while, I would respectfully ask that we all lower our car windows for the best possible view of all they have done for me. So, in conclusion, there is no way I can possibly give a eulogy for my wife, my mom, that would add anything more to all the stories and tributes I've heard this past week. We all know that Pat was one of a kind in so many ways. What I will say, however, is this. After 37 years of marriage, the last four of which were unlike anything I ever expected, I have come to believe that the only reason for this ending to her life story that makes sense to me was to somehow help me become a better funeral director. That plan was made before we were even thought about. I truly believe that, and I know that it was God's plan for us. When I tearfully look over and only see shadows now where Pat once slept next to me, I will know that she will keep watch over us and make our yokes easy while she is seated at the right hand of the Father. So babe, mom, we will take down the bunting. We will raise back up the flag. We will attempt to move forward without you. And if we should get stuck, I'm sure your soft voice will be in our head saying, come on, you big ass, enough is enough already. Get back to work. There are people who need our help and our love. So, as my parents always would say to each other, I love you, babe, and I love you more. Thank you, everybody.
Before we go our separate ways and we take leave of our sister Pat, may our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness. May it strengthen our hope. One day we will joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Of angels come to greet you. May they speed you to paradise. May the Lord unfold you in his mercy. May you find eternal life. The Lord is my light and my help. Protects me from harm. The Lord is the strength of my days. Before whom should I tremble with fear? May the choirs of angels come to greet you. May they speed you to power. May the Lord unfold you in his mercy. May you find eternal life.
Rob will now put Pat's book, Pat's name, into our book of life. Before our commendation, I would like to invite all of you on behalf of the family to Tulipano for the repast after we leave the cemetery, and echo Robbie's thanks to so many groups who made this all such a wonderful celebration of an incredible life. Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we commend our beloved Sister Pat in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings you bestowed upon Pat in this life, for they were many. She in turn bestowed them upon us. Signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ.
Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant Pat and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith. Until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our sister forever. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. We take her to her place of rest.
famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings your refuge, his faithfulness your shield. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings.
Our sister Pat has gone to her rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome her to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, we assist her with our prayers. We pray for also ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with Pat. Together may we meet Christ Jesus when you as her life appeared in glory. We read in the scripture, "Come, you are blessed by my Father, says the Lord, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the dawn of time." Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you made holy the graves of all who believe in you, thus making the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection even if it claims us. Grant that Pat may sleep here in peace until you awaken her to glory, for you are the resurrection and the life. Then she will see you face to face, and in your light will see light, and know the splendor of God who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Ensure in certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our sister Pat, and we commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make her face to shine, make his face to shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift up his countenance upon her and give her peace.
Our sister Pat, we therefore pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, "I am the resurrection and the life." Lord, our response for everyone will be, "Lord, have mercy." Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Pat and dry the tears of those who weep. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. You raise the dead to life. Give to our sister eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
You promise paradise to the repentant thief. Bring Pat to the joys of heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Our sister Pat was washed in baptism, anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give her fellowship with all the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Pat was nourished with your body and blood. Grant her a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of Pat. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. My friends, with longing for the coming of God's kingdom, we pray in the words he gave us,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Amen.
God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant Pat. Do not count her deeds against her, for in her heart she desired to do your will. As her faith united her with your people on earth, so may your mercy join her to the angels in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bow your head and pray for God's blessing.
Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people are cried in their need and strengthen their goodness. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord.
And let perpetual light shine upon her.
May Pat rest in peace.
Amen.
May Pat's soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son. May take Pat unto himself in the kingdom of heaven where Lazarus is poor no longer, and bless everyone who remains, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Father Mike, Deacon Kelder, and all the clergy who have been so supportive to Pat, not just today, but throughout her entire life. Ladies and gentlemen, formal thank yous will come in a moment. I would just ask that you remain where you are until the next announcements encourage you where to go next. It's been joked about yesterday and today, but it's so true. One never said Rob without saying Pat, and one never said Pat without saying Rob. It rolls off the tongue. It leans, you want to just yearn for more. Get it? Rob taught me that, everybody. He has asked that there be two musical selections played at this time. I think they're self-explanatory, but when you all join us for that reception later, and Pat loved a good party and loved to entertain, and we really hope you join us there. A little bit more on why these particular songs, but the words certainly are self-explanatory, so we encourage you to listen with your hearts.
Thank you.
She lives in you, Rob.
When she calls my name, nobody says it quite the same. Gives me a feeling I never knew. Makes me so happy loving her. every day.